Today I'm going to show you how to put together my Mardi Gras pop-up card. There are multiple pieces to this project. And we're going to start with the actual pop-up piece so that we can get the overlays to dry while we are working on the rest of the card. These green pieces that I am putting out are the pop-up, and then the yellow and purple are the overlays. And there are actually two pieces of the pop art that doesn't have overlays, and that is these two pieces, and they are actually the center of the pop-up. And I think I have found all of the little pieces. And there's two more. Okay. We're going to start with this piece, which is one of the masks. It's a feather mask. And on this side of it, we are going to put the purple overlay. Each side will get a different color, except for the jester hat one. So they'll get the same colors on both sides. And we're going to glue this on top. And this one, we're going to glue the purple on this side too. So actually the purple will go on the same side of both of these. And then when we put this together, they'll be facing the other direction. Put that on there, and then we're going to turn these over. There are two of the feather masks, there are two of the jester hats, and four of the face masks. And we're going to put a yellow one on that side. Let that dry for a few minutes. And then we're going to turn this one over. We'll set that one up there. And put the other yellow feather mask, here it is, on this one. And we'll set that one aside to dry. Next, we're going to take the jester hats, and actually, these are the same on both sides. So we're going to put a purple piece on the left, and then a yellow piece on the right. And we're going to do the same thing for this one. The yellow piece on the right, and then we're going to flip this one over and the purple goes on the left. Yellow will go on the right. This way, when you're looking at them from any direction, they look the same. Oops. And we'll let that one dry. We're going to turn this one over. That one. Okay, there are the jester hats done. Now for the masks. There are four of these. And I'm trying to see here. This one, you want to put the purple on the outside. For a little bit, and then I'm going to take one of these. As you can see, this one the mask is in the middle, this one the mask is on the side. We're actually going to flip this one because these two are going to go together, and we're going to put a yellow mask on this side. This one over and put the yellow mask on. That way these two will be done. There, that one. And we're just gonna, I'm just gonna flip this one back like that. Put it up there. This one we're gonna turn over and put a purple mask on. Kind of get a little gluey doing this. Let's see. And we're we're gonna flip it back. That way we put those two together. And then these two. This one goes this way, and this one gets a purple mask on this side. Again, as you can see, the mask is over here on the left. And this one is going to attach to. We're going to put the yellow mask on this one. And turn this one over and put the yellow mask on the back. And we'll just flip it back so that we know these two go together. And we're gonna put the black purple mask on the back of this one. Like that. And we'll flip this one back over because we want the yellow side up. And there are our overlays done. Next, we'll start putting the card together. And we're going to use some blue dots, or zots, some companies call them, to put the beads on the middle of the card. And these are your beads. You should have four pieces, one purple, one yellow, and two green. And then these are the middle of the card. And you'll notice that each one of these has a slit, and so they go this way because you want your slits in the middle of the card, because that is where your pop-up is actually going to attach to your inner panels. And the reason I had the circles drawn on whenever I cut this out is so that I could match up where the beads actually go. Sometimes are fun if you have them upside down, which I think I do. Okay, so, yep. As you can see, the purple beads go there, and then the yellow beads are going to go here, and then the two green will go up there. Using glue dots, we're going to put a dot on about every third bead. two more on this one. I want to make sure there's at least a glue dot on the two ends and a few in the middle. And what we're going to do is we're going to line this up. And you're probably not going to see the little marks once this goes on. And I did these with a Cricut pen, one of the 0.4s or 0.04s, so that it was a very light. And then we're going to do this side. And this one will line up with these circles. And again, you're probably not going to see the circles once you get this all on there. There you go. And we have the two green pieces. There. And that one goes there. And these are going to overlap these ones a little bit, which is fine. This one is going to go there, and this one two panels of the card. Now we're going to set these aside, and we're going to put together the pop-up base, since these should be dry. And we're going to start with these two pieces. And all you need to do is you need to put the two slits together like this, and there is the center of your pop-up base. gonna turn it this way so that I can match it up with the one I've already done. Let's see here. The next pieces that go on are the Chester hat, and you have, trying to see here, you have one hat that will go here. And then the other hat, you're actually going to turn it this way, so it's the opposite way of the other one, and it's going to go on there. And then the next pieces are going to be your two feathers, and they actually go here. So you're gonna put, let me see here. Nope, there she go. Let me turn this a little bit. They go here. Yeah. And you're gonna want the feather on this side to be the opposite. You see there's room? Because you don't want to button up against this one. So we're going to pick this up gently. Try not to lose any of it. And we're gonna slide this centerpiece down over this slit. And actually this one, try this again. Okay, we're going to slide this up in. And we're going to take this piece, and we're going to connect these two slits together. And then we're going to connect these two slits together. So it looks like that. Then this one is going to go on this side. And again, the opposite, just like these. And we're going to put the middle slit down over. As you build this, it kind of holds together a little better. Trying to connect these two. And you just have to be gentle doing this because you don't want to rip anything. And just put that one down there. And then and there are those two. Okay. Now, the outer pieces are your masks. I'm trying to look here. So we want this set. And they will go here. And you'll notice these ones have four slits on them instead of three, and that is because you're going to join them to the one next to them. Okay, we got that one. And what we're going to do is we're going to fold this little tab out. That way when we set this back down, it's flat. And then we're going to just go ahead and fold this little tab out, because remember I said the yellow paste was out on this one, and we are going to, let's see here, we're going to start on this end, and we're going to put this tab here, and then this one goes over. Under, okay, and then as I said, these two ends will actually go together like that. And I'm actually going to bend them back some. Now we're going to turn this around, and we have these two. So we're going to bend this one down like that, because this one goes on this side. So we're going to start back there. And put that piece down, and then we're going to go under here. And then over this one. And then the last piece, which is this piece, we're going to fold this one up. And I didn't put score lines on these, but they fold very easily. And we're going to start at this end, because this goes under. And then this one goes over. And then under. And then we're going to connect it to end sides. And there is your pop-up base. And the nice part is, whenever you put this all together, it won't fall apart because of the way we did the overs and unders. Okay. Okay, for this next piece, you're actually going to need regular tape, not the double-sided tape. We are going to need it in a little bit, but first we're going to put the pop-up piece connected to the inside panels of the card. And the way we do that is, and it doesn't matter which side goes on which, because you're going to be able to see this from either side. We're going to take these two little tabs and we're going to slide them into the slit. And we're going to press them in until they are even, as you can see. And then we're going to turn this over. And we're going to put tape on it. And we're going to just put some tape right there. And that'll hold your tabs in, so they're not going to move. And like I did with the other side, we're going to press these back some, so that we can take these two tabs and put them in here. You just gotta wiggle it in. And again, get the tabs all the way in so that it's flush with the card there. And we're going to turn this over and again put another piece of tape to hold the tabs. That way your inner panels are done. You just need to connect them to the outside of the card, and as you see, you can turn this over and nothing falls out. This is the outer piece of the card, and there is a score line on it, so we just need to fold the score line and then we're going to open this back up and we're going to put the inner panels on the outside of the card. We're going to try to get them centered as best as possible. I am putting them close to the edge out here and trying to center at the top and the bottom. That way, when you open and close the card, as you can see with this one, it all folds in. So I'm going to cut some double-sided tape strips and I am going to add them a little bit so I can put this one in. And what I'll do is just move this so you can see I've got a strip here and a strip there, and now I need to put one here. And we're actually going to do the same thing on the other side. That way we don't have to mess with it with the cord on there. I'm actually not going to put any double-sided tape in the middle. I didn't adhere the middle of the card, the panels, on the original one I did, because you really don't need it. The card actually holds together. Just another small piece. There we go. Actually, it says Mardi Gras on the front. And remember, the green goes at the top. So now we are going to get these all lined up again. as I said, we're going to be closer to the outer edge and center it from the top and bottom. And I'm just going to reach under here and peel the stuff off the tape. And then I'm going to just seal where the tape is. And then turn this around. And we're going to get the top piece. And seal that one. Reach under here. I got this lined up and I'm going to peel. These off and then lay the card back down. And then all these top pieces off and lay them down. And there is the center of your pop-up. And as you can see, when you fold it, it all folds up. And you may have to adjust it when it opens, but your center of your pop-up. And the only thing left for us to do is the front of the card. And there is a jester hat that goes on the front. And again, the jester hat has three pieces. Going to glue these pieces on. Like that. I'm going to get some foam glue dots that are a little larger, and we are going to put them on the back. Okay, on the back of the hat, we are going to put some small glue foam dots on. just putting these around the outer edge and a few in the middle. That way the hat's not flush with the card and it sticks out. And I think one more to it. And we're going to center the hat on the card like this. And then we have three gold bevels. We're going to use the big glue foam dots. We're going to put them on the back of the bell. And we're going to put the bells like they're coming off the tips of the hat points. And there is our Mardi Gras pop-up card. It is complete. As you can see, it just folds back up. And you can put it in an envelope and mail it.